Hello, I'm Ty Mason of thediabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today, I want to talk to you about what high blood sugar feels like. Now, after you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plan, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are tons of diabetes friendly recipes for everyone. Now for those of you watching with diabetes, you probably know the answer to this question, but I have been asked from those with diabetes this question before. Hyperglycemia, high blood sugar, high blood glucose, is a sign for all types of diabetes. The body can no longer regulate the blood sugar in your blood for one of two reasons. Either the pancreas is no longer making enough insulin, or the body's cells have become so resistant to insulin that the pancreas cannot keep up. Now, either way, the result is that glucose is accumulating in the bloodstream rather than being moved into the cells. What does this feel like? How does your body react? Well, now let me first say that you may feel some or all of the symptoms we discussed today. Hyperglycemia can affect different people in different ways, but there are some symptoms that are common among most people with diabetes or prediabetes. There are three most common symptoms, and we'll discuss those, but there are others. Now, the most common signs of high blood sugar I call polycubed. There are three polys. The first, polyuria. Now this is excessive urination. You are constantly needing to run to the bathroom, like at least once an hour, if not more often. This is caused by a dual chain reaction. The cells are pumping water into the bloodstream to try to dilute the glucose and bring it back to normal. And the kidneys, unable to reabsorb this fluid during its filtering, well, they are uncontrollably flushing water from the body. The result? Runaway urination. The second poly is polydipsia. That's the result of polyuria. It is excessive thirst. This is the response to the dehydrating effect of polyuria. It's the body's attempt to rehydrate itself. You see, the relationship between excessive urination and excessive thirst is often misinterpreted by people experiencing high blood glucose, especially before diabetes is diagnosed. Many people assume that the excessive urination is caused by the excessive thirst and not the other way around. So they are quick to discount the excessive urination, thinking, well, I've been drinking a lot lately. When in reality, you're drinking a lot lately because of the urination. That's causing it. So a lot of people get that one backwards. Number three, polyphagia. And that's the final main symptom of high blood glucose. It's an excessive hunger. It is not so much caused by the high blood glucose level as it is a low insulin level. The amount of insulin in the blood is insufficient to move glucose molecules from the bloodstream into the cells where they can be used as fuel for cellular processes. If the cells aren't able to gain access to glucose, they send out hunger signals, and the brain's hypothalamus triggers the sensation of hunger. Now, those are the three main signs of high blood sugar, the polycubed. Most everyone who has a blood sugar level above 150 will experience at least one, if not all, of those symptoms, usually at least two of them. Another symptom you may feel is fatigue. Your body is working so hard to regulate your blood sugar, your cells can't get the fuel they need to work properly, and this will cause you to feel very tired. You'll want to rest constantly. Now, as the glucose levels rise in your bloodstream, other symptoms are possible to appear. One that is very common of others I've talked to is blurred vision. Sometimes you see what I call little snowmen in your peripheral vision. This is the beginning of a diabetic retinopathy. The tiny blood vessels in your eyes cannot carry the thicker blood, causing oxygen levels in the optic nerve to drop. You may also experience one or more of the following, after days of high blood glucose levels, rapid deep breathing, a fast heart rate, a weak pulse, a strong fruity breath odor, loss of appetite, tummy pain or even vomiting, lightheadedness, headache, unexplained rapid weight loss, tingling in your hands or feet, scratches or sores that seem to take forever to heal. Now, it's difficult to answer what each individual will feel like when their blood sugar is high. It really depends on the individual and how high the blood glucose level is. Believe it or not, there are people who feel worse when their blood glucose levels are normal. They get used to how it feels to have an elevated blood sugar, and normal is not normal to them. If you experienced any two of the polycubed symptoms and you have not been diagnosed with diabetes, you should get to your healthcare provider as soon as possible and just ask them to check your blood glucose level. If you have diabetes and you experience any of the other symptoms, you need to make sure you keep a check on your blood sugar, and if it remains high, see your healthcare provider and ask for an A1C test. This can help tell how long your blood levels have been high. You may need to have your medication adjusted. High blood sugar is not something to just dismiss. It can have very serious consequences. If you even suspect you have high blood sugar, contact your healthcare provider. I hope you have found this video helpful. Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.